I'm in a relationship with someone who I accurately know is unhealthy for me, but I'm not able to give it up. How do we gather the strength to let go of someone whom you have been with for so long and loved so much? Well, the first piece of this is we really have to ask ourselves, and it's good, this ties in nicely with the first question. We really have to ask ourselves, what do we mean by being unhealthy for me? And that requires a lot of real introspection. So for example, I like to be right. Now, if I were in a relationship with someone who were telling me that I was wrong, that would be difficult for me because I have, you could say, and I'm not, I don't necessarily mean me specifically, I'm playing roles here. I do like to be right anyway, but we'll play it a little bit even bigger. I've got an attachment to being right all the time about everything. Everything has to be my way or no way. Because I am the smartest. I am the one who knows everything. And so everything has to be my way. So now let's say I get in a relationship with someone who has the audacity to say to me, maybe not in the beginning, or I wouldn't have fallen in love in the first place. Maybe in the beginning when he was courting me, he thought, wow, God, she's really smart. Yeah, that's right. Wow, that's also right. And then as we got closer, maybe he started seeing that my need to be right was actually not due to me knowing so much, but due to my fear of my own vulnerability, due to my own fear of the unknown, my fear of my worthiness. Would I be worthy if I didn't know everything? Would I be worthy if I weren't right all the time? And so he started to pick up on this, and he also noticed some things that I said that just absolutely were not right. And so he started saying to me, you know, this isn't right. That's not right. Now, if I'm still super attached in being right, to being right, I may convince myself this guy is not right for me. This guy is unhealthy for me. Look at the way he's insulting me. Look at the way he's putting me down. I need to be with someone who makes me feel good about myself, right? I mean, we can rationalize anything. I need to be with someone who's, you know, filling me and helping me grow, not somebody who's telling me I'm wrong. Well, in that particular case, being told I was wrong really would be the most important thing for my growth, if I could take it. It would force me to look at my addiction to being right. It would force me to sit in a place of vulnerability of sometimes having to say, I don't know. But my ego, if I weren't able to look at it, if I weren't already on a path psychologically and spiritually of looking at the self, my ego could absolutely convince me this guy is not good for me. And I could go out and tell my friends, God, you know, he's constantly telling me I'm wrong. He's got no respect for me. And of course, my friends would say, well, then dump him. My God, he sounds horrible. Who needs that? Right? I mean, you need somebody who's going to make you feel full and complete and whole. And so you see how I could rationalize getting out of a relationship that really was good. Now, I don't know anything else about this man, but at least that part was good. That part was challenging me in a safe environment to look at my own stuff, to force me to grow. But my ego, if it's scared of growing, I'm going to convince myself this guy's wrong for me. And so I would say the first thing to do is really, if we've convinced ourselves the relationship is unhealthy, to really take a look at what's unhealthy about it. Sometimes we are what's unhealthy about the relationship. And unfortunately, you're stuck with yourself. You know, wherever you go, there you are. In psychology, they call it pulling location, meaning, oh, doesn't feel so good here, I'm going to feel so much better in Tahiti. But actually, when I get to Tahiti, sitting on the beach, pina colada in hand, there I am. And so I'm not actually able to run from that. So the first piece is really analyze, is it really unhealthy? And is it really the person, the other person who's unhealthy? Or is it my way of interacting that's unhealthy? And maybe the universe has given me this person to help me wake up. Otherwise, I mean, you could look at all the other things in our life we have relationships with other than people and say, well, that's unhealthy. I mean, you could say poverty is unhealthy. When the stock market crashes and I lose my life savings, that's unhealthy. Getting a disease is unhealthy, literally. Having a loved one die is unhealthy. I don't want that. I want out of that relationship with life. If we had the ability, a lot of us would get out of those relationships in which we lose that which we care about. Now, we don't have that ability. We can't walk away from the stock market that has crashed, the loved one who has passed away. And what that does, the reason I mention it, is it forces us to realize, well, God, you know, the universe that's so committed to my awakening, that's so committed to my unfolding, that's so committed to me discovering who I am and uniting with God, keeps throwing me these things that don't feel good. And what that teaches us is that feeling good is not always synonymous with what we need on our spiritual path. Now, of course, that does not mean be a masochist and, you know, force yourself to stay in situations that are horrible for you. But it just means be honest with yourself and really check within about what is it I'm walking away from? And might this not actually simply be an opportunity that the universe has given me for personal growth? And I'm passing it away. You know, Pujaswamiji gives a beautiful saying of Lakshmiji, who's considered to be the goddess of wealth and prosperity. He says, you know, sometimes Lakshmiji comes to tilak us, means to, you know, to bless us, to put the tilak on our head, but we've turned our face in the other direction. So the goddess is there, but we've turned our face in the other direction. And so I would say for the first aspect of this, make sure that you're not turning your face away from actually that which is supposed to be on your plate right now. If it really is unhealthy, if it's undeniably unhealthy, for example, you're being abused emotionally, physically, sexually, in any way. In any way you're being abused, it's unhealthy, get out. Or if there are other ways that you know you're being manipulated, you're being made to feel small, you're being whatever it may be, that you really, really know is a situation you cannot grow in. Well, that's where we have the courage to walk away from it. But those situations are much, much rarer than most of us think. Pujaswamiji also says frequently, he says, you know, leaving is losing. If you've been given a situation, you've been given it for a reason. But these days, so many of us have become so habituated to sort of instant gratification. You know, drive-through food and ATM machines, you need money, you stick your card in, you get money, you drive around a window, you get food. You need something, you go online in 30 seconds, now on your phone, Amazon, it's here the next day, sometimes the same day. Soon they'll have drones. You know, I mean, you'll think it basically. And some smart something you're wearing will know that you're thinking it and will connect with Amazon or whoever is working at that time, and the drone will drop it in your lap. So we've become so habituated to getting everything immediately. Having so many options. Don't like this one? Okay, take this one. Don't like that? Take this. The world literally has opened up to us over the last couple decades. I mean, literally in a way unprecedented in history. But along with that fantastic opening of the world has become this belief that somehow there's something better than what we have. If I just look a little harder, that website, this shopping site, this one, that dating site, this, whatever it may be that I'm looking for, I'm going to find it somewhere better somewhere else. And it's really important that we not let the marketing of technology seep into the beat of our hearts and change how we move through our relationships in the world. So if it really is unhealthy, get out. I mean, yeah, it takes a little bit of willpower. If you're diabetic and the doctor says, stop eating laddus. Okay, you want to eat them. You love them. You've always eaten laddus. But at some point, you're going to choose your health over the laddus. Every time you eat one, you have a, you know, diabetic crash. Eventually, you stop eating them or you die. One or the other. So if you want to live, you stop eating the laddus. You stop eating the cake. In the same way, as addicted as we may be or comfortable as we may be on some warped level in a relationship that really is abusive, you've got the same choice the diabetic has. Either leave it or die. Physically, emotionally, spiritually. But, as I said, worth emphasizing again at the end, those are the very rare situations. In the vast, overwhelming majority of situations, it's our ego that has gotten uncomfortable with a situation and therefore has convinced us that it is unhealthy for us simply because it doesn't feel good with my current ego identification. So be careful of those, because then otherwise you just spend your life running from relationship to relationship to relationship.